What are you saying?
Mom, what does this mean? Where is Flint? Where is he?
My baby, Amber, where are you?
Mom, Dad, what's going on? No! Flint! Go get him! Why are you standing here?
Get that kid out of here! He's not safe!
No, please! Dad, we have to find him! We can't leave! We have to find him! So bad. It was me who made you into a monster. You exist because of me, because I refuse to accept. You want it back. This piece of you, don't you? You're not so bad. It was me who made you into a monster. You exist because of me, because I refuse to accept. You want it back, this piece of you, don't you? I remembered everything. I understand now, at least, that it wasn't my fault. Sometimes life is unfair. Ted taught me that. If I hadn't eaten that cookie, we would have been home when it happened. Maybe Flint would have gotten out okay, but maybe someone else would get hurt. No one can know that. All I know is that I miss him so much. I thought if I pretend he's just hiding, that maybe, I don't know, that maybe I could see him again somehow. I didn't feel so helpless anymore. Somewhere along the way, I got lost in my own fantasy, and it got difficult for me to stop pretending. Mom and Dad told me so many times it wasn't my fault, but I wouldn't accept it, and I know now that was wrong. You can't outrun sadness, so there's no point in trying. The only way to get over something is just to face it head on. I guess in his own way, that was what Red was trying to do. He was destroying this fabrication I made around myself in hopes of reaching me. But it was only when I lost Ted, too, that I got the strength to stand up to him. And I see now it was what he wanted all along. I know I'll never see Flint again, and it makes me sad. But as Ted once said, life gets sad sometimes. All I have to do is push through, and happiness will find me again. I need to get some sleep now. I'll be wiser tomorrow. After all, it's going to be a brand new day.
Mm-hmm.